ओके विल स्टार्ट। सो वंस अगेन गुड आफ्टरनून टू एवरीवन। लास्ट वी कैन स्टडी द डिफरेंट डिजिटल वीडियो फॉर्मेट। ओके सो फॉर द डिजिटल वीडियो यूज द टीओ 01। ओके सो इन दिस फॉर्मेट वी कैन यूज द डिफरेंट स्पेसिफिकेशंस। नाउ हाउ वी कैन सेलेक्ट एडिट वीडियोस फिली द वीडियो प्रोसेसिंग। सो वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड वीडियोस। सो हाउ वी कैन द वीडियो। ओके सो इन ऑर्डर टू फॉर्म द वीडियो या इन ऑर्डर टू मेक वीडियो वी कैन स्टडी द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वीडियो कैमरा। ओके सो बाय यूजिंग द वीडियो कैमरा सो सिंपली वी कैन कैप्चर दी ऑर्डर टू मेक अ गुड क्लैरिटी वीडियो वी हैव टू कंसिडर द वेरियस वीडियो फॉर्मेट्स। ओके सो वी कैन यूज वेरियस डिवाइसेस टू कैप्चर द वीडियोज। ओके सो बाय यूजिंग द वेरियस डिवाइसेस वी कैन कैप्चर अ वीडियो एंड इन ऑर्डर टू स्टोर दैट पर्टिकुलर वीडियो सो वी कैन यूज द वेरियस स्टोरेज डिवाइसेस। ओके सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी कैन ऑल्सो डिस्कस द वेरियस डिजिटल वीडियो फॉर्मेट्स। सो एवरी वन लुक एट द स्क्रीन। सो हियर वी कैन कंसिडर द डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स फॉर अ डिजिटल वीडियोज। So here we can consider the two types of channels. So one is a Luma channel and another is a Chroma channel. Okay. So by using these two things, we can consider the various digital video formats. Okay. So basically, form of video. Yeah. Basically, why we can use a video for. Yeah. Basically, why we can use video. Okay, so by using a video, we can describe the much more information. Okay, so we can also define the definition of image also. So by looking at the images, so rather than writing a thousand words, so image can explains the much more information. But as we look at a video, so video can explains much of information as compared to the image. Okay, so in video formats, there are two types of channels can be used. One is a Luma channel and another is a Chroma channels. Okay, so depending on these two channels, so there are the different specifications. Okay, my voice is clear. Hello, आवाज़ तेरे को व्यवस्थित? Yes, I am audible. Okay, so as we discussed in yesterday's lecture, so we can consider the two major specifications. One is the sampling frequency and another is a bit rate. Okay, so here we can consider the different specifications for a two channels. One is a Luma channel and second one is a Chroma channels. So we can consider the various parameters are the sampling frequency, then the bandwidth, then number of samples per line, then number of samples per active line, and the most important is the bit rate. Okay, so what indicates the bit rate? So how much data we can transmitted on a single line. Okay, so there are number of lines in a video frames. So there are standard is a 625 lines are present in a digital videos. So for that we have to study the different types of scannings. So we can use vertical scanning, horizontal scanning. Okay, so with the help of its diagrams also we are going to study what is a vertical scanning and what is a horizontal scanning. Okay, so on each line, so we can transmit the data. So for that we can use the bit rate. So the bit rate in case of Luma channel is 108 Mbps, and in case of a Chroma channel is a 216 Mbps. Okay, so here we can consider the two different types of lines. So in some digital frames we can use a 525 lines, and in some video frames we can use the 625 lines. Now what is a 525 lines or what is a 625 lines? Okay, so if we study the diagrams of vertical scanning and horizontal scanning, then we'll understand what is exactly meaning of these particular lines. Okay, so in this format we can consider the different types of channels. Okay, so here we can use a Luma channel with a 525 lines, also with the 625 lines. Okay, so what are the lines? How we can represent the lines by using the scannings? Okay, so only understood, only the remember. So these are the two channels are used in the digital video formats. So one is a Luma channel and another is a Chroma channel. Okay. 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 So now when we refer with a video, so we have to consider the different types of frames. Okay. So as we studied in a images, so we can use the three primary colors. That is a red, green, and blue. Okay. So in images, also we can study the various types of compression techniques. Okay. So in a videos also, if we have to compress the videos, okay, so by using the video compression techniques we can compress any video. Okay, so in the videos there are the three different frames. Okay, one is I frame, second is a P frame, and third one is a B frame. Okay, so these three frames are required for the video compression. Okay, so similarly in our images also we can study the different types of compression techniques. Okay, so in video processing, so there are two main types of compression techniques. One is a lossy compression technique and another is a lossless compression techniques. Okay, so we have only two techniques, and these three frames are used for the video compressions: I frame, P frame, and B frames. Okay, so okay, so now next thing is we need to understood what are the different lines. So we mentioned 525 lines, or we can mention 625 lines. Okay, so if we observe our television, so instead of television there is a camera tube. So it might be a two-dimensional or three-dimensional tube. Okay, so in camera tube, okay, so it is a simple picture of a camera tube. Okay, so if we observe a television, so inside of television we can find out a camera tube. Okay, so by using this camera tube we can look the various videos or various pictures. Okay, so if we consider the any videos, it might be a two-dimensional signal or it might be a three-dimensional signal. So we have to scan the data in a particular orientations. So we can scan it from the top to bottom, or left to right, or right to left. So for that, we can study the different types of scanning techniques. Okay, so first one is a horizontal scanning, and the second one is a vertical scanning. Okay, so this is a simple frame diagram for the horizontal scanning. Okay, so if we transmit the data from the left side to the right side, so that is called as a trace line. Okay, so always remember it. So when we scan the data, when we transmit the data from the left side to the right side, so that is called as the trace lines. And when we travel, when we move the data from right side to the left side, that is called as a retrace line. Okay, so with the help of this particular structure, we can mention the horizontal scanning. Okay, so if we consider the various channels, if we consider the Luma channel or Chroma channel, so depending on a channel, we can consider these particular number of lines. So it might be a 525 lines or it might be a 625 lines. So depending on a channel, which channel we can use in a videos, so based on that channel, so we can use the different lines. Okay, so if we consider the Chroma channel, so nowadays instead of a Luma channel, so in every television, so in every cameras, so the Chroma channels can be used. So it consists of the 625 lines. So that can be represented with the trace and retrace. So when we call as a trace, so when it travel from left side to the right side, and when we called retrace, so when it travels from the right side to the left side, so that is called as a trace and retrace. Okay, and the second thing is that the vertical scanning. Okay, so in vertical scanning, so instead of left to right or right to left, so the data can be travel from the top to bottom. Okay, so here we can consider the different types of lines. So it might be called as a trace lines, or it might be called as a retrace line. So if when we called as a trace line and when we called as a retrace line, so in a vertical scanning, when the data is moved from top to bottom, it is called as a trace lines. And if the data is travel from bottom to top, it is called as a vertical scanning. Okay, so with the help of its moving position, we can represent the vertical scanning and horizontal scanning. Okay, so in horizontal scanning, if the data is moved from left to right, it is called as a trace. And if the data is moved from right to left, it is called as a retrace. And in vertical scanning, so we have to consider if the from top to bottom, it is a trace, and the bottom to top, it is a retrace. Okay, so by using this structure, we can mention the vertical scanning and horizontal scanning. Okay, so along with the vertical scanning and horizontal scanning, there is a one more structure which is called as a interlaced scanning. Okay, so it is a basic difference between vertical scanning, horizontal scanning, and interlaced scanning. Okay, so now everyone listen carefully. So when we use the interlaced scanning, so we can use the vertical and horizontal scanning in a single frame. Okay, so if we observe a structure of this frame, so if it consists of the 625 lines in a single frame, so here we can consider the two fields. One is called as a field one and another is called as a field. So from the top to bottom, we can consider from 1 to 313 and at right side 313 to 625. Okay, so by using a single frame we can mention the 625 lines. So if the lines are 625, then it can use the chroma channel. Okay, so it is a structure of a interlaced scanning. So with the help of trace and retrace, we can represent the interlaced scanning. Okay, so in interlaced scanning, so there are the different representations. So we can use, we can scan the sequence of images by in any position. So we can use the different vertical retrace. So it might be called as, in first retrace we can use some lines, in second retrace we can use half of the lines. Okay, so we can divide the total number of lines, that are the 625 lines, into the smaller number of groups. Okay, and at the end, if we add all the lines, so the addition should be 625. Okay, so to avoid the complexity, so we can also divide the 625 lines into the smaller groups. Okay, so it is possible in case of a interlaced scanning. Okay, so these are the basic types of scanning. One is a vertical scanning, horizontal scanning, and the interlaced scanning. Okay, so these are the three important concepts regarding the video processing. Okay, so in sixth unit, we have to study the two major points. One is the working principle of videos, the working principle of video camera, and another is the different types of scannings. Okay, so in scannings, we can study the three different types: vertical scanning, horizontal scanning, and the interlaced scanning. Okay, so these are the two important points in a unit number six, and the three different frames. One is a I frame, second is a P frame, and third one is a B frame. Okay, so basically these three frames can be used for the video compression techniques. Okay, and we have to again study the various advantages and disadvantages of the video signals. So can anyone tell what are the advantage of video? What is the advantages of video? If the video is not in exist, so what are the disadvantages? So can anyone tell what are the different advantages and disadvantages of videos or video processing? Yes. What are the different advantages and disadvantages of a video signals, and where it can be used? Okay, so we have to study the advantages, disadvantages, and applications. So now tell me the various advantages of videos and disadvantages of videos. Yes, quickly. Where we can use the videos? In which applications we can use a video? Yes, quickly. So it is a last point of unit number six: advantages, disadvantages, and applications of the videos. So now quickly tell me the एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ अ वीडियो। एस एनीवन? रोल नंबर 37 उपेंद्र। रोल नंबर 37 इज दिया। रोल नंबर 45। यस, इफ योर रिस्पॉन्स इज नॉट देयर आई विल नॉट कंसिडर योर अटेंडेंस। ओके, वन इज गिव्स मोर इंफॉर्मेशन इन अ शॉर्ट टाइम। ओके, वनली एडवांटेज। यस, अनदर। रोल नंबर 13। स्टिल एनी वन एडवांटेज, एनी वन डिसएडवांटेज और एनी वन एप्लीकेशंस। नो वन? ओके, सो इन टुमारोज लेक्चर सो यू हैव टू टेल एनी वन एडवांटेज, एनी वन डिसएडवांटेज और एनी वन एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ अ वीडियो सिग्नल और अ वीडियो प्रोसेसिंग। ओके, सो देन ओनली आई विल कंसिडर योर टुडेज अटेंडेंस। ओके ओके, सो हियर वी कैन कंप्लीट द यूनिट नंबर 6। सो इन यूनिट नंबर 6 वी हैव टू स्टडी द थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स। सो वन इज अ वट इज अ वीडियो एंड वट आर द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ अ वीडियो। ओके, सो वीडियो इज द सिक्वेंस ऑफ इमेजेस। देन सेकेंड पॉइंट इज अ वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वीडियो एंड द थर्ड पॉइंट इज अ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ स्कैनिंग। ओके, सो इन टुमारोज लेक्चर सो यू हैव टू टेल द एडवांटेज डिसएडवांटेज एंड applications of a video processing. So then we'll start the unit number 7. Okay, so it is clear. So if you tell the various advantage, disadvantage and applications, then only I'll consider your today's attendance. Okay. So now you can put your numbers. Okay, so everyone go through the study materials. So I'll change the links setting so everyone can now access the links. So go through the study materials. So if you have any doubts to access the link, then you can inform to me. Okay. Okay. So those who put your numbers, you can leave now.
हेलो सर, 52।